Just gonna cast my desktop. Alright, so before I start, feel free to ask questions at any time. Whenever something pops up in your mind, just raise your hand or shout it in or whatever you'd like. So, who has ever made a Rails application that had a RESTful API in it? Probably a lot, probably most of us, that's great. And has anyone ever heard of GraphQL or even made a project with GraphQL? Great, so thanks for listening, that was it. But actually I'm gonna talk about what GraphQL is, even though a lot of you already know it, and how it is here to actually make our lives easier, and also when we should use it and when we should not use it. So let's start with an example. Imagine you make let's say a blog that has a front end and a back end, and the back end is made with Rails. And now let's assume that in Rails you have a REST API and it has an article resource that has several different attributes. Now the client only needs the title of each article. So nothing else, no body, no images, no whatever. In REST, what would be the most efficient way to get this data, or what would be different possibilities to get this data? Does anyone have an idea? I thought everyone does REST applications. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So the most conventional way would be to just get everything, all articles, and then only display the titles. The problem, if you have 10 attributes, then you are getting 10 times more data than you actually need. And is there a different option in REST? Any idea? Yes. Yeah, we could do that. For example, that would be a good solution. It would kind of break the convention a bit, in my opinion. But yeah, valid point. We could also make a parameter, an option, for example, that's called only title. The problem with that is that we would have to write documentation for it, so the users would know which parameters exist, and it would make our code a bit more messy. And as most of you probably already know, there's a clean solution for that in GraphQL. We'll look at that later. Let's first look at a different example. So let's assume we also have comments for articles. So one article has multiple comments, and a comment belongs to an article. And now the front end needs all articles and also the latest two comments for each article. How could we get this data? Ideas? Okay, so here it depends a little bit on how we set up the REST API. If we, for example, would have slash articles and then slash comments, that would be really bad because we would have to make a request for each article to get its comments. So if we have 100 articles, we would have to make 101 requests. And let's say we have one resource that gets us all articles and one that gets all comments. Then we could get them in two requests and then just match them in the front end, so we only have the latest two. But as you can see, it's two requests and a lot of data that we actually don't need. So quite inefficient. So now I want to show you how we can do it in GraphQL. So on the left side, you can see how a REST client, REST API works. You just have your different endpoints, and well, you call one, and then it gets its data from one or multiple models. And on the right, we see how GraphQL works. the whole application only has one single endpoint. So we just call that endpoint. It's usually just your URL slash GraphQL. And then you can tell that endpoint exactly what it is you need. So for in our example, we could say we only need the title of each article. Then GraphQL goes and fetches that data, and it gives us exactly what we need, nothing more and nothing less, in one single response. So that's really efficient. Now I would like to show you how this works in action, how we can implement this. So I made a small Rails app that already has GraphQL implemented. And now we are going to write the query for it together. So first we just get the localhost, then slash GraphQL. Yeah, right. Thanks. No. Yeah. Sorry. Yeah. Okay. Let's try if it works. Okay. Great. So I have a Chrome extension that just displays JSON a bit nicer. So actually, this is just the JSON response. And it says that we don't have a query. So let's write the query. And we will pass the query as parameter in here. And who knows how to add a parameter to a URL? Great, thanks. So the parameter is called query. And the syntax is really easy. We just use the curly brace. Then we say article. Then we use another curly brace. Actually, I think it's articles. Yes. And then we say title, because we only want the title. So now let's try if this works. So we get the article with all the titles. By the way, this data is generated by the FakerDRAM, so I'm not responsible for that. Now, the second example, if you remember, we needed all the articles and the latest two comments for each article. So now we can just add all the attributes you want, in this case just title and body. Then, because comments is a child of articles, we can just write comments. Then make another curly brace for the attributes of the comments. Here you want body. And let's see if this works. So now we get all the articles, title, body, and all the comments for it nicely formatted in JSON. Now we only want the latest two comments. So what we can do now is we can add a parameter, in this example latest, and then just pass the value to. That's important to note. The latest, that's not some default by GraphQL. You have to really implement this yourself, but the good thing is you can implement anything you want. Now it only gives us two. And this is quite cool, because I think it's almost impossible to get exactly this in one single request with REST. And yeah, more requests just makes your application slower. So this is really nice. GraphQL is implemented in the backend. So actually your front end makes requests to the backend, and then GraphQL is in the backend. Yeah, exactly. So you can get 10 different data from 10 different models, but it's only one request. Yes. Is the question answered? Okay.
That's the specification. Yeah, there's a bit. Actually, you're doing.
Yeah.
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 Yeah,
I can show it. It's just it's not that not that efficient code, so it calls the database more than it would need. But can you read it? Basically, you have a controller that's just a GraphQL controller. Here, by the way, if you install the gem, all of this code gets generated automatically. Then you have a query type here. And here you can specify which fields you want to make accessible with the GraphQL endpoint, and also what they return and how they call the database. And yeah, so you're free to customize it however you want.
Yeah.
In this example, no, not on the database level. I think you could do it if you wrote the code differently.
Yeah,
I'm not sure. Yeah, obviously, yes. No, I was just talking about the network request, so it doesn't send the whole article to the front end, only the title. But on a database level, you're right. Yeah, it would be possible. So, yeah. Yes, let's see that. No, not here. Here. All right, let's turn back. Yeah, so as you see, you can actually make any parameter and use it as you like. So I would like to give you some final thoughts. First of all, just flexibility. It's the great advantage of GraphQL. I think we already talked about that a lot. Then mutations, they are like the counterpart to post requests in REST. So yeah, you have quite a similar syntax to queries, and it's just used to modify data. Yeah. And what I also want to say is that with this article, with this presentation, I just kind of scratched the surface of what is possible with GraphQL. It's really cool, and feel free to check it out. And you also don't have to decide between GraphQL or REST. What a lot of people do is they have a project that's built up with REST, and they add something new, a new feature on top of it. They only use GraphQL for that new feature. That's very well possible. Then also, you're in good company. That means companies like Facebook, Twitter, GitHub, and the New York Times, they all use GraphQL. So this is unlikely to get deprecated soon. And yeah, any further questions? Yes?
One is, have you ever used GraphQL endpoint from
No, I haven't done that. Yeah, I used it a lot.
It's pretty cool.
Yeah.
I think one of the main benefits for GraphQL exposing test is you have like on where from as a time.
I can actually show this really quickly. This is quite interesting. Yes, that's true. Actually, I didn't want to use it for the presentation because I wanted to show how it really gives a JSON response, but this is a great point. So you get this with GraphQL, and here it kind of makes an automatic documentation for everything you got. And then here you can like test your queries, and then, okay, this doesn't work. Oh, it does work, actually. I thought this was an error. So, yeah, you could because it was red. So, yeah, you can get, you can test your API here, and it's great for development because of the documentation. Great point. Yes. Yeah.
I think this alone is not an argument against REST. REST by the also explorable. Also know what types are from certain resource.
Yeah, that's true.
If you would have a swagger, yeah, okay, you're right. Better with swagger,
you have to write it.
Yes.
I also like about GraphQL that it's very easy to version it.
This
real page in REST.
Yeah. A lot of people even encourage you to don't do versioning, so they call it versionless API. The reason for this is that because it's so flexible, you don't really have to have breaking changes, so you don't have to make new versions. That's really cool. Any more questions? Okay, in this case, yeah, thanks.
Thank you very much for your attention.